I raised the issue of marriage as I was feeling a bit insecure. So without saying anything, he took out the blade from his wallet, put a cut in his thumb, and filled my mouth with his blood. Vikram for the first time in 1995 at Punjab University Chandigarh when we both had joined MA English there. But as fate would have it, neither he nor I completed it. I guess it was just destiny playing its part in bringing us together to share our lives and become an integral part of each other. I can still vividly recall the air of excitement in his voice when he had called up to tell me that he had got selected for the IMA. That news had in fact, you know, put the seal on our relationship. But at times later on, because we used to be apart a lot, whenever I used to get pressurized regarding the issue of a marriage, he always used to tell me, "Take care to get what you like, or you'll be forced to like what you get." I still try to follow that in my life. It was a kind of a ritual with us to visit Mansa Devi Temple and Gurdwara Sri Nada Sahib. On one such visit to the Gurdwara, while doing a prakarma of the Nishan Sahib, he was walking behind me. On completing the prakarma, he suddenly said, "Congratulations, Mrs. Batra." I swirled around to see him holding one end of my dupatta. He gave me a very beautiful smile and said, "Didn't you realize this is the fourth time that we are doing this prakarma?" Needless to say, it left me totally speechless. So that was the level of dedication and commitment he had towards our relationship. He was a man on the go, very restless, had to be doing something at all times, couldn't sit still even for a moment. While waiting for an order in a restaurant, he would start tapping the bike keys on the table. On being stopped from doing that, he would start tapping his fingers on the table. Again, on being asked to stop, he would start tapping his feet. And finally on being given a stern look, he would start drinking water. And drink water as if he had been thirsty for ages. So now when I recall all this, I can feel what he must be going through during the Kargil war. What his state of mind must have been. He must be feeling restless inside, raring to go. On one of his visits from Supur, I raised the issue of marriage as I was feeling a bit insecure. So without saying anything, he took out the blade from his wallet, put a cut in his thumb, and filled my mouth with his blood. So that is the most cherished moment of my life till date. Though later on, I used to tease him that he is pura filmy. How do I describe a lifetime of memories, though made only in 4 years of association? I could go on, and the memories would still keep coming. Not a single day in this past 17 years I've felt alone or detached from you in any sense. It seems as if you are away on a posting. I feel so proud when people talk about your accomplishments, but along with that, there's some regret too in some corner of my heart. You should have been here sharing, listening to the stories of your brave deeds, of how you're an inspiration for the youth of today. I know in my heart we are going to meet one day. It is just a matter of time.